Hey everybody, how's life treating you? I'm Russ Robo, and welcome to the Russ Robo Channel News for February 2019. It's actually kind of funny to be doing a 2019. I have to distinguish now between 2018 and 2019. Actually, I don't think I started the Russ Robo Channel News until like sometime in August or something last year. I'm not sure. I'll have to look that up. But I've written down a few bullet points to talk about for the beginning of the month and what all we did in February and what all to be looking forward to in March. And it's and some of the things that I did that were actually kind of fun this month that I just thought I'd put on there. All right, so first on the bullet point is getting into some of the more advanced characters in Naruto Battle Climax. I'm actually really happy to say that I'm getting into some of the Kages now. I just did the Mizukage and Tsuchikage, one and then the other, and then I think I is next, so that's gonna be another one, and who else, I already did Gaara. The Akatsuki come soon after that, and all the like really strong, powerful characters towards the end of the game. And the way I want to finish it out is I think Naruto the last and Sasuke the last, combining those two together in a single episode. Like I'll play as one, and then have the other one as my NPC partner. And then play as the other one, and have the other one as my NPC partner. Alright, and the next bullet point is that I actually got to try out two new games this month. One was Crash World, and the other one was Hovership Havoc. They were pretty fun. I didn't realize that Crash World had already actually been done and spoofed and all that good stuff, but I had fun playing with it. It was a pretty fun game. Just sort of like GTA style, but Legos. Legos graphics, it was funny. It's definitely good for a good laugh. Hovership Havoc, I really like that one. I'm not sure if it was the developer, it might have been. They said thanks for playing the game. We really appreciate it. It was probably the developer. Glad you were able to beat the demo. And I was like, yeah, great, I actually enjoyed it. It was a really fun game. I'm hoping to see that one develop and continue on in that style. You know, I wouldn't change much of anything. I like the idea of customizing the ships. I wonder what the other three ships are like, because you can only use one in the demo. I didn't see an option to buy it, so I guess it's still in like a beta testing thing. I don't know if you can go past the demo. I'll have to look into that. But that was pretty fun. I enjoyed that game. All right, and the next bullet point that I wrote down was finally getting into the official matches on Robot Arena 2's Star Core AI, Lightweight, oh god, it's such a long name, but I want to keep the Tournament of Robotic Champions as part of it, because that's my thing, you know, that's the only thing that I can contribute to it, because I write down the brackets and all that, so that's why I choose the name Tournament of Robotic Champions. But finally, we're through the preliminaries, so you know, lightweights from the same team don't have to fight anymore to see who will represent their team. We have the representing bots, and actually the first episode's already up as to the airing of this, because I was supposed to do the Russ Robo Channel News February last week, but I got really busy, and I needed to go and do things, do other things. I do other things. Like I have a life outside of YouTube. No, I don't. I just work for Walmart, and then I come home and I make videos and then I go to sleep. Oh man, but it's actually been a pretty fun one. Drink my coffee out of a straw. Actually, I just used that to stir. But that was actually really fun. I really like some of the matches on there. They're pretty interesting, so I'm really enjoying watching some of those. And I'll be looking forward to seeing some of the middleweights. What I have debated, not debated, but what I have debated is I don't know whether or not I should make my own bot for the competition, because the last two seasons I got eaten alive. Every single time I make a robot for one of these tournaments, I just get smashed. I think I came pretty close in the heavyweight tournament. Actually, yeah, wasn't I in second place? I lost to, like, Emergency in Season 1. Yeah, I think so. But I guess I could give it a shot, try to build myself a nice lightweight. I've still got plenty of time. We've got frickin' 20 teams to go through. That's all there is for that. All right. And the last bullet point is just some of the fun stuff that I did this month. I actually got to go to the Panama City Mardi Gras Parade in St. Andrews. I always start to say downtown St. Andrews, but it's just St. Andrews. That was really fun. I got to hang out with all my Amp Guard buddies. We LARP, you know, with the live action role play, you know, foam swords and the outfits and get-ups. I was dressed as a pirate, and we got to walk next to a float, throw beads at everybody, you know, Mardi Gras style, all that good stuff. And then on the way back, you know, and they actually asked us, they asked our park to help represent them, because they knew about our park from, I guess, they drove by and saw us one day. And of course, anybody drives by, we're immediately going to introduce them to our park and what we do, because we're proud of it. We like what we do. So they actually asked us to represent their float in the Mardi Gras Day Parade. Excuse me. Because their float, like many of the others out there, was pirate themed, because, you know, Panama City's so close to the water and there's water everywhere. So there were a lot of pirate themed boats this year, and there probably are every year. And since they saw us out there, we were playing, doing Amp Guard stuff, and most of us dress up as pirates or barbarians or what have you. And they realized what we do, and they wanted us to represent their float. So I was sitting there waving the sword around, being a good showman, you know, walking, dancing to the music, all sorts of stuff. It was great. Then on the way back, we actually got to ride in the float with, you know, the people throwing the beads. It was great. It was great. I got to be a part of the parade, and they had, man, for refreshments, they were like, you want some water? And I tried some of that out. You know, they poured me a little, I put some ice in a glass, and I poured me a little bit, because they had it in a big old, the pitchers, like you see in football games, for Gatorade. You know, they had one of those big gallon things, 10-gallon pitcher, and I tried some of that. I never had Hunch Punch before. Apparently, they just put, like, you know, like, fruit punch or tropical punch or whatever with several different kinds of alcohol in it. And that was really good. It tasted like a screwdriver, but it was just something they called Hunch Punch. Me and Aurora had some, and some of my other buddies had some, and one of my buddies was like, I'll take some water, and the guy that made it stopped him. He's like, oh no, that's adults only water, because he was like 18 or 19 or maybe 20. He's almost there. I even got a little bit of sunburn, kind of a little bit of sun, as you can tell, because in all my videos you can easily see how pale I am, and now I'm kind of like burnt red because I was out all day in the sun. But gosh, it was so fun. I'm sorry I'm rambling on. My last part was I wanted to tell you that, the videos should come out as regularly scheduled, but I'll actually be gone next week from Friday to Sunday for our Amp Guard Kingdom event. I think it's the Kingdom Coronation, which would make it either end rain or mid rain. I'm not sure how that whole thing works. But it's like a 6-hour drive, and I'm going to carpool with somebody because I finally managed to get Fridays and Saturdays off on a regular from my job. And the event happens to take place on Friday and Saturday. And they said we'll be back early Sunday, so I'm hoping I have time to recover. I'm not going to try to exert myself too far, because they at Walmart, they took our absences, the amount that we're allowed to have, and chopped it in half. And I'm already at 2, and you only get 5. So it's like, oh well, great. If I go to this nice, you know, event with all my Amp Guard peeps, you know, like, could be 30, 60 people show up, and we're all gonna be out there like exercising in the hot heat. Then I'm gonna get back and be ridiculously tired and not be able to work and have to call in on Sunday, and that'll put me at 3, and then I only got 2, and then I'm fired. Oh man. But it's been a crazy month on February. I'm looking forward to what's gonna happen in March, and I mean, I might as well say it has been, you know, a crazy month in February, because it's not gonna be crazy. Like, this is the 25th. I that was another thing I wanted to mention, is I'm sad I couldn't get this channel news out at the first of the month like I did last time. I was like, I got the channel news out the first of the month. Yay, it's a miracle. And then that's what I get for bragging. Shouldn't have done that. But hey, you know, you do what you do, and you got what you got, and then you get what you get. So Hopefully you all enjoyed the videos this month and next month. I certainly enjoy making them. If you have any helpful comments, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. And as always, until next time, when I stop stuttering, take it easy, my friends.